How many of you are BCom graduates, completed BCom? Oh, okay. How many of you are in your fifth and sixth semester of BCom? Okay. Third and fourth semester of BCom? Okay. First and second semester of BCom? Okay. Any of you have come from a non-commerce field, not from science background? Okay. Science? Okay. Science background. Okay. How many of you are from CPT and foundation, that route? Okay. CPT foundation route, is it? Okay. So that means rest of you are from the direct entry route?
Yes.
That is BCom route? Yes? Okay, fine. Your subject is called taxation. I think till yesterday you had, yesterday you had a holiday. Correct? In that holiday, was there any homework given to you?
Yes.
By Mayur?
No.
Nikit gave you homework, is it? Whose class you had before this?
Yes.
You had accounts by?
Yes.
Acha, okay. Fine. And yesterday you had a holiday. And there was some homework given?
Yes.
Did you do that homework?
Yes.
Okay, he asked me to find out. You're done? Okay. Now your subject is called taxation. When you say taxation, it means revenue of the government. Revenue of government. Now the revenue of government is the taxes. So what's a tax? It's nothing but the revenue of the government. Looks like you get revenues, we get revenues, your parents get revenues. Here the government also gets revenues, and the revenues of the government is called taxes. All the taxes, that is all the revenues of the government, is popularly classified into two parts, one called DT and the other one called IDT. DT meaning?
Direct taxes.
IDT meaning?
Indirect taxes.
Classic example of a DT is income tax. Income tax is a classic example of DT. The classic example of IDT is GST. Before we used to have excise duty, service tax, etc. But today we have it as GST. The main distinction between a direct tax and a indirect tax is two economic words. And these two words are called as incidence and impact. So we use two words. One called incidence, one called impact. Incidence means the liability to pay tax. The liability to pay tax is called incidence. Impact means the burden of the tax. If the incidence and impact is on the same person, if it's on the same person, then it is called direct taxes. Whereas if the incidence and impact is on two different people, if it's on different people, different persons, then it is called indirect tax. So the only distinction between a DT and IDT is these two words called incidence and impact, that is liability and burden. Just to make you understand what this means, let's say there is a seller and there is a buyer. Now if you are the buyer, you went to that shop of the seller and you bought one soap. So you went to that shop and you bought one soap. The question that comes up is, you would have paid some money when you buy the soap. Then you went home. The moment you went home, will the GST officer come in his jeep, knock the doors of your house and says, knock, knock, you bought one soap, give tax. Will he come? That means the liability to pay GST tax is never on you. He will go and ask whom? He'll ask the seller. That means the liability to pay GST. The liability to pay GST is on the seller. Although the liability to pay GST is on the seller, will he pay the GST from his pocket? He would have collected the money from the buyer. So he would have done something like this. He would have told soap is 18 rupees, 2 rupees is GST, and therefore he would have collected 20 rupees from you, which means ultimately he is the one who is going to pay the GST, which is the liability is on him. But does he feel the burden of the tax? No, he doesn't feel the burden of the tax, because the burden of the tax is on buyer. So we say incidence is on the seller, whereas the impact of the tax is on the buyer. So when the incidence and impact is on two different people, it becomes a indirect tax. Whereas if we come this side, let's say Mr. A has got 10 lakhs of income. Let's say he's got a 10 lakhs of business income. He's carrying on business and he's got a business income of 10 lakhs. If Mr. A has business income of 10 lakhs, who is liable to pay tax on the 10 lakhs? Mr. A. Now, once income tax officer tells Mr. A, you have to pay tax on 10 lakhs. Now, will Mr. A collect this money from Pakudmane, meaning from neighboring house, saying that, hey, look, I have to pay tax, so give, or he has to pay from his pocket. He has to pay from his pocket. That means the impact, that is the burden of the tax, is also on Mr. A. Incidence and impact both are on Mr. A. We call it as a direct tax. So one is called DT and one is called IDT. If you can go into, I hope you've got the notebooks. Notebooks matlab yashas material. All of you, do you have the yashas material given to you? Okay, can you go to page number 4? Page number 4. Can you see a beautiful chart in page number 4? No? What do you find? Yeah, you're going to write the beautiful chart now, right? The beautiful chart will come now, right? Write it and then you can see a beautiful chart in page number 4. All of you done? Done? Your paper is for 100 marks. So you got this total for 100 marks. This 100 marks paper is divided into DT and IDT, which means you'll have DT for 60 marks. DT for 60 marks, and you'll have IDT for 40 marks. So therefore, this entire paper is divided as 60 and 40. You will have 40 for GST and you'll have 60 for income tax. So therefore, this chart is what you have in your syllabus, in the sense your syllabus is totally 100 marks. 100 marks consisting of 60 of DT and 40 of IDT. You can add that into your chart as 60 and 40. Added. Yes? Okay. So I think you understood the whole concept of DT and IDT. Yes? Okay. Now there are a few things that you need to understand. If you are done. Done? Let's say 3-4 friends of you are standing outside. Outside means not in this corridor. Outside meaning that road. So 3-4 friends of you are standing there on that road. And obviously, if 3-4 friends of you are standing there, buck, non-stop, you'll be shouting and screaming and talking something. So let's say 3-4 friends of you are standing there on the road and you're talking something. And let's say, surprisingly, you're discussing the subject. Normally, it does not happen, but surprisingly, you're discussing the subject. And you're discussing the subject about accountancy. Telling that, hey, this is the way you're supposed to, some subject you're discussing, saying that, hey, you know what, this is the way you're supposed to solve the problem. And your friend is arguing, no, that's not the way to solve the problem. This is the way to solve the problem. And both of you are arguing and major argument is happening. Hey, then what nonsense, this is how you should solve it. And your friend, no, that's not the way, this is how, that's what he told, this is how you should solve. And you're having an argument on how to solve the problem. As you're having an argument, some stranger who is walking on that road pokes his nose into your group and he says, there is one more way of solving the problem. Typical human tendency, you will look at him from top to bottom. Obviously, you will look at him from top to bottom and you will say, who the hell are you to interfere in our group? Human tendency. You'll look at him and say, who the hell are you to interfere in our group? Therefore, ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce myself as to who the hell am I to interfere into your subject of taxation, right? So let me introduce myself, because your subject taxation, who the hell am I to interfere suddenly to come and poke my nose into your group. So let me introduce myself. My name is Vijay. Vijay Raja, like how they say Bond, James Bond, right? Okay. But I can't tell it in the style in which he says, that is Bond, James Bond. I'll have to say Vijay Raja, because according to Indian PAN card rules and Aadhaar card rules, very clearly told, first name should be first only, last name should be last only, because PAN card has to be linked with Aadhaar card. Otherwise, they'll say name mismatch and all they will tell. And therefore, I cannot reverse the order. First name, first only, last name, last only. We can't change that order. So my name is Vijay Raja. I'm basically a commerce graduate, BCom. Like some of you said that you're also a graduate. So I'm also a commerce graduate, BCom, secure 28th rank from Bangalore University. And the most amazing part about a CA student, something which is very amazing about a CA student, which is very typical only for a CA student. It's only a CA student who is a big time conjuice, big time stingy miser. Conjuice means conjuice. Stingy people, CA students. Because I just now told I've completed BCom, I've secured 28th rank for Bangalore University, nobody clapped also for that. I mean, Anyway, let me start from first, probably. It'll have, Fashinda will start, okay? Like how when you are kids, when you used to play cricket, as kids, you'll stand for cricket, we'll all fighting, you'll stand for cricket. First ball will say, no, Fashinda. Fashinda, idu adu devarge. That is for God. That's for God, grace ball. We'll start Fashinda. So I'll start again, okay, Fashinda. So let's start Fashinda, okay? My name is Vijay Raja. I'm basically a commerce graduate, BCom. I've secured 28th rank from Bangalore City. Thank you. That's it. Thank you. Very nice to see many of you appreciating it. But at the same time, I saw some of these people still did not clap. Many of you clapped, very nice of you, but there are some of them who did not clap. Now, if I ask them, hey, why you did not clap? I said, BCom and all is below our dignity. You have done something, Salpa Mariyada is there, you tell, some level is there, you tell, BCom and all will not clap. So for the sake of those people, I'll have to continue my introduction. So apart from doing BCom, I'm also an advocate, LLB, I've secured university first rank.
Very good.
Very good. So apart from doing BCom and LLB, I'm also a cost accountant from the Institute of Cost and Works Accountants of India, ICWAI. I have secured All India third rank, right? Okay. That's in costing. That is the costing institute. I'm also a chartered accountant from the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. Okay. I'm a gold medalist in CA. Right. Okay. So apart from BCom, LLB, cost accountant, chartered accountant, I'm also a company secretary from the Institute of Company Secretaries of India. Thank you. I've also done my Master of Science in Psychology. I'm an MSc in Psychology, right? Okay. Thank you. Now some of them stopped clapping. Agalama. Yes, avagina clap maartare. No. You please complete. After you complete, you tell full stop, then we'll start. How many times to clap? Okay, fine. Rest of the introduction we'll give later because they've stopped already. Amish to clap. Anyway, this was a new law created called as IBC. It's called as the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code. It was a new law created from the All India Board called as IBBI, and they started to conduct some examinations to become an IP. It's called as an insolvency professional. So that's a new exam that they have started, wherein who can write that exam is only those who have completed 10 years of CA experience. First of all, you have to be a CA. First of all, you have to be a CA. After becoming a CA, you must have 10 years of experience. After that, you're allowed to write that IBC examination. And in that, one among 100 will pass. That's a, first of all, CA only, one among 100, that's our situation. And then again in IBC exam, one among 100. So I'm also an insolvency professional from the IBC. So I've also qualified as a professional for that. Okay, thank you. As far as teaching is concerned, it's my hobby, it's my passion to teach. I love to teach, therefore I'm teaching. But otherwise, my bread and butter is from my office. I'm a practicing chartered accountant. My office is Guru and Jana, chartered accountants. That's my office. So, but as far as teaching is concerned, since I love to be with students, therefore it's a passion to teach, I'm teaching. But as far as teaching professional students is concerned, when I say professional students, means students of CA, ICWA, CS, they're called professional students. So as far as teaching professional students is concerned, I started to teach only recently. Recently in the sense, my first teaching was in 1992-93, the first time I started to teach. So I've got more than 25 years of teaching experience in professional field, right? Okay. Huh. Some of them are wondering, I was not born also. So by looking at you, I can say safely that my experience is greater than your age itself. Yeah, and because I've done psychology, psychology. Yeah, if I say psychology, you will not know correct spelling. Cycle and all will come. So, CYC, so. But if I say psychology, correct spelling will come. So for correct spelling, we'll have to say psychology. Now, because I've done my psychology, now when I tell this my introduction about what I've done and all those things, and now I told you that I'm teaching from 92, 93 onwards, I can see question mark on your head. That's why I've done psychology. So that I can make out what is happening inside you. So I can see the question marks on your head wherein people are, Oda, what's his age? I can understand that psychology on your head. That's why I've done MSc also. That's the reason why I did psychology. I can see that question. Stupid. You are sitting here in the class to qualify as a chartered accountant. So your first doubt should have been, what is the secret of your success? You have done so many qualifications. You're not bothered about that part. Hey, what's his age? Does he use Fair and Lovely? Does he use some Santoor? Patai nahi chalta. What's his age? Nonsense. You come for a beauty contest or what? Yeah. Your focus should not be on that. Your focus should have been, hey, he has been a rank holder everywhere. In all the courses he has done, he has been a rank holder. There must be some secret of success. One exam, by mistake, if it happens, it's okay. By mistake, ha gaya rank. But every examination he has taken and every course he's taken, he's been successful, he's been a rank holder. There must be some formula, secret formula, and there should be some secrets of success. Your focus should have been on that. Thinking, hey, what's your secret of So whatever secrets of success are there, all the secrets of success will be shared with you. Don't worry. It will not remain as a secret anymore. I will share everything with you. But I will not tell you everything on the first day. If I tell everything in the first day, second day will not come only. Because you will tell, I know everything now, it's okay. I can take care of it. So I will tell you in installment scheme. Little by little, over a period of time, I'll be explaining to you all the secrets of success. It'll be taken care of, right? Because it's my first class, I have a few announcements, a few instructions to give. So just first understand all these instructions, because my first class, I need to tell you all those instructions. Number one, I hope you understand. Now, you had Niket's class, right? It used to start at? What time? Starts at? Seven? Yes. It starts at?
Seven.
Seven? Now, I know how to say seven. Okay, but I'll say seven. I know how to say two, but I'll say chew. I'll say chew. Now, just because I say chew, you don't look at your neighbor and say, Papa.
He does not know how to pronounce also.
Yeah, he doesn't know how to say two, he doesn't know how to say seven. I know. But I will say seven, I'll say chew. So when I explain to you something like April, May, June, July, now again told Papa. Yeah? He's telling June, July. He doesn't know how to, I know. I know how to say June, July, but I will say June, July, and all that. I will tell. Okay? So you don't discuss Papa. He doesn't know anything at all. Your class used to start at?
Seven.
It used to start at?
Seven.
Your class was starting at 7, but my class will start at 7:30. Nah, that's not war. Listen. Listen. You have to revise before I start my class for half an hour. You have to revise for half an hour. So either you come at 6:30 and start revising from 6:30 to 7 so that I can start the class at 7. Or you come at 7 and revise till 7:30, so I'll come at 7:30. 7:30 better, sir. 6:30 chance illa. Yeah. For 7:30. Otherwise, 6:30. You have to come at 6:30, revise the topic, then I'll start the class at 7. Because half an hour, you have to revise my topic, because my topic will have a lot of intricacies and everything is memory based. The whole aspect is, it's a law. Once it's a law,
A Lord does not care for any logics. Now, I cannot teach you in law saying that debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Atharella logic illa. We don't have such logics in law. Lord does not have any such logics. And therefore, it's a memory game. You can't use some logic and say, logically this is an asset, this is a... That way you cannot logically understand and do something. Not possible. It's a law. And law requires a lot of a memory game. And therefore, you have to keep revising constantly on a daily basis. So every day, half an hour, you have to revise before I start my class. So therefore, two options only. You have to come at 6:30 and from 6:30 to 7, because otherwise I'll close the door at 6:30. Before 6:30, you have to come. We'll close the doors at 6:30. You'll not be allowed inside. So 6:30 to 7, you have to revise. So that 7, I'll come. In the tumba aithu sir, agalla. Then okay, then I'll come at 7:30. But please, you have to come at 7. Ensure you're here at 7 and some 7 to 7:30. You revise and then we'll start at 7:30. Done. Done.
Yes, sir.
So 7:30 does not mean you'll come aram say, half an hour extra mil gaya abhi. It's not like that. Right, you have to be here by 7. Right, you will be here by 7. Done.
Yes.
Okay. This is the first rule that you have to follow. You have to be here by 7 and ensure you start revising what's done. If you have not understood something, discuss with your neighbors. If your neighbor is unable to explain to you, throw that neighbor and find a better neighbor who can explain whatever has been done in the class. And that's your job. Did you understand this aspect? Yes. Okay, that is one. Second, I think you all know it, don't use mobiles in the class and don't disturb the class because of your mobiles. Don't keep mobiles in a visible mode also, wherein some of you, I say don't use, but you'll keep it like that only. Once in a while, it keeps, then hi, and then you keep, no, don't allow your mobile to disturb either you or then your neighbors or me. So I don't want your mobiles to disturb in the class. Are you clear?
Yes, sir.
And I hope you understand all these classes are copyrighted classes. Copyrighted classes in the sense that you do not have any right to do any recordings of the class. You do not have any right to either do the audio recordings or video recordings. You're not supposed to do any of these things. These are all copyrighted classes. Are you clear with this? Like how you go to a movie. When you go to a movie, can you say, I will take a video of this song? Can you do that? Can you, if somebody comes and, hey, what you're taking video? Kaas kotilva. I paid now for the movie ticket. What you have paid for the movie ticket is to watch the movie, not to take video of the movie. Do you understand this? So here also what you have paid and come is to attend the classes and not to take video recording. I'm telling you for your own good because you've got, you know, all the CCTV cameras everywhere put up and by chance you are caught doing that, you are gone. Because the copyright